Hello friends, so we'll start a new essay today in our series. It is the 12th essay of adversity. Adversity and prosperity, they are opposites. So adversity means a time of suffering, a time when you have to face great difficulties in your life. Everybody has this, I think. One or the other way we'll have a period of adversity. What we say, zodiac people will say, Rahu ka. Rahu. Yes. So then you have got the prosperity, that is zodiac, means in certain zodiacs they will say vyada, according to a certain way of predicting your future. Okay. So adversity means a tough time in life. Introduction, that is first point is, in prosperity and adversity, there are blessings. That's first point. One, in prosperity and adversity, there are blessings or good things. Sometimes we will think that only in prosperity there are good things. It's not like that. In adversity also, those things that you get in at the time of prosperity, you wish for, you like, your desires are fulfilled. But time of adversity, what happens is that you are admired by people because you are suffering admiration. The other is, your wishes, your desires are fulfilled. In adversity, you suffer. When people see your suffering, they admire you. For example, we can see the story of Pandavas, you know, Kauravas and Pandavas. The Pandavas, 12 years of life in forest, and then 1 year of life incognito, 13 years, have tough time, but they learn many things. That's the thing. They learn many things. Also, you have the story of Joseph in the Old Testament. His brothers sold him. And all the struggles that he had. Finally, what happened? He became a minister, the chief minister, the advisor to Egyptian Pharaoh. So that is, you admire all the struggling that you are admiring. Your life also, you will find that. Some misunderstanding will do. Some people misunderstand. So your adversity begins. And you come out of that. Then you start putting all your energy, and you will say that there will be light at the end of the tunnel someday. So then people will admire you when you come out successful. Think of all the freedom fighters. How many times they went to jail? Mahatma Gandhi, then Jawaharlal Nehru, and Gopalakrishna Gokhale, Balgangadhar Tilak. So they had the times of adversity. But they all came out as heroes. That's the thing. Prosperity has its blessing, adversity also has its blessing. So it depends how you look at it. And then second point is, there is, connected to this, you think about divine providence. So you will think that when you are in adversity, you are suffering, you will think of divine providence. And you will say, in my insecurity is my security. Insecurity is my security. What is insecurity mean? The sufferings that you have. What is security? God's providence. That's the thing. So you trust in God at that time. Your trust in God will definitely become, it will be confirmed source. But this, of course, you find only in among poets and in works of fiction, according to Bacon, this. And for example, we find Hercules, the story. Bacon quotes the story of Hercules, who sailed a great length of the ocean in a pot, a small pot or a pitcher, P-I-T-C-H-E-R. That is, because he was sure that he had got the support of gods. And he went to travel so long to liberate Prometheus, Prometheus who stole fire from heaven and gave it to man. And therefore what happened? When it was found that Prometheus was the thief, Jupiter bound him, and Hercules went to liberate him. And the journey is the length of a great ocean that he did on a pitcher or a pot. But he believed that nothing will happen because he has the providence of God, the support of God. But this, Pagan says, it's only in stories. Understand that? Christians also have the same belief. Suffering is heroic virtue for Christians. Suffering. Hopkins' poem, The Window, where you can see. At the end of the poem, you will find that suffering is glorified. Especially profitless suffering is glorified. All the Christian saints, you can see, they practice the heroic virtues of suffering. In the canonization ceremony to be celebrated, the Pope will come out and read out, or somebody who is in charge of that will read out that and give the list of the heroic virtues practiced by that particular person, so that he will be raised to, or she will be raised to sainthood. Sometimes it may be martyrdom. So that is, suffering is adversity. But the result of adversity is they practice, or the blessing of adversity is they practice heroic virtues, become heroes. So you cannot say that adversity is anything bad, or it is something, it is a curse sent by God. No, in that also you can see the blessings of God. Because finally, you will be admired for practicing heroic virtues. And the third is, what are the virtues of prosperity? Virtues of prosperity and virtues of adversity. Virtues of prosperity, as we already seen, they are wished for, or they are desired for. Everybody likes it. The virtues of property ought to be temperance. Temperance is a character, moderation. You are very rich, that doesn't mean that you should spend all your money. You remember in the Bible there is a story, you know, of a rich man who had a bumper harvest. Then he was thinking, oh my soul, be happy. We will drink, we will enjoy. Then what happened is that next morning he was found dead. So that should not have been his attitude. He should have said temperance, he should have practiced temperance, the virtue of temperance, and he would say, he should have said that, oh, I have got bumper harvest. I will share it with my neighbors. I will share it with those people who don't have. That should have been there. That is temperance. But in this case, what happened? He is, I will do this, I will do that, my soul. Happy, drink. Eat, drink, and be merry, and things like that. So next thing he died. This is story, but the temperance is very important. When you have got money, you are very rich, you are the number one, like Bill Gates or somebody like that. So what you should do is, you should practice moderation, temperance. That is the virtue that you have to practice, moderation. What about adversity? Adversity is fortitude. So here you should be temperance, you have to practice, or moderation. Medium level. Here it is fortitude means strength of character. You can say when people, you beat some people, you know, they become very strong. That is it. They don't cry. Okay, mama. They become very strong. So that is the blessing of, or the virtue that you should practice. The virtue that you should practice when you are prosperous is temperance. The virtue that you should practice when you are suffering is fortitude. Don't give in and don't give up. Think of Nelson Mandela. How many years within the bars. And then Vegan goes on to say that Old Testament you have prosperity, blessing. New Testament you have an adversary. The Old Testament, God is always with them. God blesses everybody who goes there. But in the New Testament there is only suffering. For example, Jesus suffered crucifixion. Then finally, resurrection. So, Good Friday, it will definitely be followed by resurrection. That's the point. And then he says, what is attractive to people? It is suffering. Because in the Old Testament, we have two characters. One, Solomon, with all his luxury. There is descriptions of Solomon and his glory, splendor, magnificence, spectacular palaces, events, and so on. But there is another one, Job, sufferings of Job. Bacon says, the Holy Ghost, that is inspiration, labored much to describe the sufferings of Job, while the luxuries of Solomon, not very attractive. If you read the sufferings of Job, that is more attractive than the description of the luxuries and the prosperity of King Solomon. So what attracts you is the highlight. Understand? Then he said, he gives an example. For example, needlework and embroidery. In a dark background, the needlework is better to see. But in a lightsome background, bright background, if you make a needlework, that will not be as attractive as the needlework or embroidery done in a dark background. Dark here represents adversity, and brilliant light here represents prosperity. So what you do in prosperity is not very attractive, but what you do in adversity is more attractive. And again he gives an example from nature. He says there are some sweet smelling medicinal leaves. If you pluck one and smell nothing, but you will crush it, that sweet odor will come out. Sweet smell will come out, like that. If you want to see the real character of a person, crush him. That is, allow him to pass through adversity. Then you will see the sweet odor coming from. Odor, O-D-O-U-R, means smell. O-D-O-U-R. That comes out of the man. That is, figurative language means you will see the real metal of the. You can say, no? Enter the ninja. It's a martial arts. Then you have got a black belt and all this. See, they have undergone that training. Sir Master, lot of, how many years of training is required? That is actually adversely imposed upon you. It is created for you, so to say. So that your real metal will come out. Like crushing the leaf of a medicinal plant, then you will get the smell of it. Tulasi, for example. Tulasi, everybody knows. You take the leaf and crush it, and then the sweet smell. Otherwise, the smell, but not the thick smell. You won't be able to enjoy. So that is what Bacon also says. Bacon says, and that is a fact. So these are the three main points in this essay. This is the shortest, one of the shortest essays, I think. So first of all, in prosperity and adversity, you get the both, for both are good for men. When you have sufferings or dark days or tragic days, don't curse, but instead wait. There will be silver lining in the cloud. Wait for a bright future. So in adversity, there are blessings. And prosperity, blessings are that blessings that you wish, blessings that you are waiting for, blessings that you embrace. But adversities are not blessings that you enjoy, but it is blessings to be admired. Your behavior, etc., should be admired. Then, divine providence, insecurity, etc., these are you find in poetry. And in fiction, for example, he says about this Hercules and his journey to unbound Prometheus. He said he traveled length of great ocean in a pitcher or a small pot, because he had the support of the gods. But of course, these are matter for fiction, for poetry, for story, and so on. Then Christians also the same thing. Christians, too much of belief in providence, and so suffering is heroic for them. And the virtues that you should practice, that point is that in prosperity is temperance, in adversity is fortitude. Then he says about the Old Testament and New Testament, speaks about Job and Solomon, and also needlework and embroidery, and certain leaves which you crush. For example, incense, you have to crush it, no? Incense. You have to press it like this, crush it in your hand, and the smell you get. As such, they smell, but that is very weak. A very strong smell, a thick smell, if you want to enjoy, you have to crush it. Like that. So that's, you have to pass through adversity. Understand? So hope that this is an introduction. We'll be taking up sentence by sentence as our practice is. And till then, we'll say bye, but before that, let's wash our hands and flush our corona, and that is our this week's slogan. You should spread it, you should forward this to your friends, and also this is the time of adversity for us. So this is the time we are going to fight it with all our energy, and we are going to gain the virtue of fortitude, so that in future when such struggles come, you'll be able to withstand without any difficulty. Okay, bye. Have a nice time. Enjoy your life.